Chickens are chickens, right? Commercial agriculture uses a few highly specialized breeds, but the Livestock Conservancy in Pittsboro promotes the preservation of rare or traditional breeds, also known as heritage breeds. Jeanette Berenger from the Livestock Conservancy explains why we don't want heritage breed animals to disappear.
These animals represent some diversity that would be really important for agriculture at some point. Because agriculture is dominated by commercial agriculture these days, you know, all milk cows seem to be Holsteins or beef cows or Angus, and they're bred very tightly, and when you start breeding the best of the best of the best, they end up being all related to each other. And so when any kind of problem creeps in, agriculture is going to have to turn to breeds like, you know, our heritage cattle, or in the chicken industry, they might want to turn to a heritage breed like a Buckeye for qualities that could be like disease resistance or fertility or thriving in a challenging environment.
The Livestock Conservancy is the leading organization in the U.S. working to conserve historic breeds and genetic diversity in livestock. Through education, outreach, promotion, and genetic rescues, they ensure the future of rare breed agriculture. Considering that the average U.S. farmer is over 50 years old, the Livestock Conservancy likes to start early encouraging a new generation of farmers.
We had a really great opportunity a few years back when we got approached by our friends at Chatham County Extension. And they are part of a curriculum program for biology that's required by the elementary schools, and they're required to study embryology. And so 4-H and Extension purchased a number of incubators for all the classrooms, and the kids get a chance to hatch out eggs.
Berenger asked Charles Taft of Stauber Farm in Forsyth County to provide 9 dozen eggs for the embryology program. Taft, a former Livestock Conservancy board member, started raising heritage sheep and chickens after he retired. Since he only gets about 3 dozen eggs a day from his Delaware, Buckeye, and Araucana chickens, it took some time and special handling to collect all the eggs needed.
To get an egg that you're going to incubate, when you take that egg out of the nest, you don't want to clean it up and wash it off, because there's a little protective film on that egg which is important for the incubation process. So we did not wash the eggs any at all, and we put them in my basement, which has a temperature of about 50 degrees.
After Taft collected enough eggs for the project, Berenger transported the heritage eggs from Stauber Farm to Pittsboro. Michaela Henry's fourth grade class at Pittsboro Elementary School received 15 eggs. In the classroom, the children were solely responsible for turning the eggs a couple of times a day and tracking their development over the 21-day incubation period. Henry tells what she likes about this method of teaching embryology.
I love how hands-on it is and how much the kids love it. I mean, every day when we look at our PowerPoint of what's going on inside that egg with the chick or the embryo, they are so into it and so interested in it. They know exactly the time that they're supposed to turn it, if they're turning it to an X side or an O side. They know exactly the days that they aren't supposed to turn it, and they do it all themselves.
What's really great about the program is not only do the teachers get a chance to talk about embryology, but they get to talk about conservation, and then they get to talk about breeds. And so it broadens the conversation and makes it interesting, not only for the students, but the teachers have fun with it.
Berenger also visits the classroom after the chicks have hatched. To delight the kids, she brings in a Buckeye hen that hatched in their school the previous year.
When I go back to the school, I talk about the breed and its history, and they already have that information in their handouts, because we give a breed profile so that the kids can see, you know, on paper what they look like, but there's nothing like bringing a live chicken in.
After the heritage breed chicks are hatched, they return to the farm, but not before the children get a chance to play with them. The excitement in the classroom was high the last day the chicks were there. But what exactly did the children learn about chickens?
I learned that there's 21 days for the chicks to hatch and 3 weeks because 7 times 3 is 21.
It's where you put a light through the air cell of the egg, and you can like kind of see if they're forming or not through the egg, kind of like when a mom is having a baby, they see what's inside, or an x-ray, something like that.
We have like numbers on the eggs, and we have like X's and O's. So like sometimes you turn it to O's, and then you turn them to X's, and then you turn them back to O's. But you rotate the eggs 3 times a day.
And inside the egg, a new thing, it gets heavier and heavier each day inside the egg, and new parts of the body start to form. And day one, it looks like nothing, but it keeps looking like a chick. It looks more like a chick every day.
They start out from this little dot called a germ spot, and then they form day by day, and they turn into a big chick. But when they first were in the incubator, they were all wet and stuff, and they were tired because their small bodies takes a long time to peck out of the thing. And I learned that they rotate around the egg so that their head can just pop up out of the top of the egg.
The children received eggs from 3 different kinds of heritage breed chickens. What did they learn from this?
I think they were kind of surprised by that chickens could be a rare breed, you know, because they see chickens, you know, so much, you know, whether it's in the grocery store, you know, chicken farms, you know, they see them everywhere, and I don't think they've ever thought about how they could be a rare breed. And got them to think and use their critical thinking skills, like, why might these breeds be rare? They felt like they really contributed to helping this breed, you know, the population increase some. But I think they took it more serious then. Like, this was a serious project and study that we were doing. You know, it wasn't just, oh, this is how a chick develops. But, you know, there are rare breeds. There are chickens out there, you know, that their numbers are low. And, you know, there are people out there that are wanting to help bring up those numbers. And they feel, they have that sense of pride, like, I've helped.
Word's gotten out about it, and people really excited about it. And so we try to hook up those schools with local breeders, because it's only going to work if you have a breeder in the area that's willing to supply the eggs. For the breeder, it's actually a win-win situation, because you don't have to use electricity and time to hatch out the eggs. And at the end of the project, all the chicks that are hatched go back to the breeder that provided the eggs. So it's kind of a win-win for everybody, the school, the breeder, the breed. yeah, you couldn't ask for a better project.
Through the Livestock Conservancy's outreach, elementary students in Chatham County have the opportunity to take a closer look at chickens and help conserve their genetic diversity.